Hello guys, welcome to the new session of MatPy. Here I will be taking a question which is something peculiar. Once you see the question, you will find that key nothing is given, but again then we need to find the solution for that. So the question is something like this. A quarter of a circle is given to you. Okay, this is a quarter of a circle. Then a square is given to you inside that quarter of a circle. And so this is a square. And you need to find this angle theta. So those who feel that they can solve the question or they can think of something, then please pause the video here and go for the solution. And once you complete the solution, come back and check out whether the solution is correct or wrong. Or if you have done much better than me, or if my solution is much better than you. So anything can happen. So please go through this, stop the video, and then start solving on your own. And later continue with this video. Okay? Fine. So this is the question that is given to us. So here, once we find that nothing is given, then start assuming something. Okay? And what we can assume? We cannot assume the angles here, but we can assume definitely the side as x, because it is given that it is a square. So we will take this side as x, this side also as x, this side also as x, and this side also as x, okay, because it's a square. So what I can write here is that key AB is equal to CBD is equal to CD is equal to AC, and that is what we are considering it as x. It will be much better if you consider this instead of this x, you can take any value such as 2 or 1 or something. And because finally we need to calculate the angle theta, so we can go for the ratio, trigonometric ratio. Once you are taking it as the ratio, so either you can consider it as x or you consider it as 2, the rest of the sides or the values will come according to this 2 or this x. So for the timing, I'm considering it as x, then at the end we can substitute. If it is easier for us, we can take the value as 1 or 2 or anything, then rest of the values will be calculated according to that. Okay, so from the figure, what we can see is that CB is also a radius, which is equal to CE. So this is radius, and this is also radius. Okay, the total length. Square length is x, but CF is radius. So here I can say that CF is equal to CE is equal to CB, which is equal to radius of the circle. Okay. But if you look at this triangle C, D and B, then we can apply the Pythagoras theorem. So in triangle, which triangle? CDB, we can apply the Pythagoras theorem and we say that CB square is equal to CD square plus BD square. Now what is CB? CB is R. So R square is equal to X square plus X square, because CD and BD both are X. You can look here. Okay. So R square is equal to 2 X square. Therefore R becomes X root 2. Okay, so we have calculated R in terms of X. But if you look at the figure, CF can be written as CA plus AF. CF can be written as CA plus AF. CF. This plus this length is equal to total CF. But what is CF? We are denoting CF by R. So we can say that R is equal to CA. What is CA? CA is X plus, this is AF. This is AF. CA plus AF. So what I can say? AF is equal to R minus X. Okay. AF is equal to R minus X. Why I'm calculating this AF? It is very simple that you want to calculate angle. So I can, if I can do something here, this and this, then definitely we can work on that. Okay, because I can apply for angle theta. So what we'll do is that, again, we will take the triangle. So if we consider in triangle, which one? AFB, which is like this. Okay, so this is 90 degree. This is angle theta. This is F, A and B. So if I apply tan theta, what is tan theta equal to? Tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent. See how simple the things are moving. Opposite is AB divided by AF. Okay, AB divided by AF. Now what is AB? AB is nothing but X. So I can say that this is X opposite divided by adjacent. It is AB divided by this. So X divided by AF. What is AF? R minus X. So R minus X. This is tan theta equal. Now, you know that we have expressed R in terms of X. Already we have done that. So simple, what we can do is that X divided by X root 2 minus X is nothing but tan theta. So here I can take X as common. If I take X as common in the denominator, so within bracket we are left with root 2 minus 1. Okay, this is tan theta. So X and X will get cancelled. So we are left with, see here, tan theta is equal to 1 divided by root 2 minus 1. So the only thing that we need to do now is we need to calculate theta equal to tan inverse of square 1 divided by square root of 2 minus 1. So theta can be calculated by using the calculator. So we use the calculator now. So what we need to calculate is root 2 minus 1, inverse of that, and then tan inverse. So here we go for root 2 and then minus 1. So this becomes something like 0.414. Then reverse of that, because it is 1 divided by root 2 minus 1. So 1 by x. So that gives you around 2.41 and something. And then we need to calculate tan inverse of that. So I apply the tan inverse function. So the answer is 67.5. Okay. So finally, the theta that we have got here is 67.5. Here I can write theta is equal to 67.5 degrees. Guys, you can see that the question was very easy. Only the thing is that here we have used the combination of both Pythagoras theorem as well as the trigonometric function. And initially we have guessed that the side of the square is X. And finally they have given the two things, okay? Always, because there are two unknowns. One is the radius and the other one is the side of the square. So they have given the question in such a way that you can form two equations. And once you can form two equations, you can solve for two variables. And that is how we have done that. And we have calculated theta. Video, we'll come out with a new question in the next session. Till then, take care and thank you.